Good day to the audience around the world. Today is Monday, December 14th, 2020, and it's now 11:30 p.m. in Taiwan. I'm Fiona Zhang Xinfang. Welcome to the weekly report of the World New Religion, Taiwan Wei Xin Sheng Jiao at Wei Xin TV Station. As usual, we're going to begin with the latest update of Wei Xin Sheng Jiao Amitabha Buddha birthday celebration and benediction ritual for national protection and disaster elimination. In response to the global pandemic of COVID-19, Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chan Shi is continuously leading all Wei Xin fellows to pray for the end of the pandemic and natural disasters for 196 countries in the world with this special 99-day Dharma feast. We're constantly praying for the 196 countries worldwide. May the pandemic subside eternally. The task of stir-frying the five kinds of grains has been taking place continuously. Following the schedule arranged by Wei Xin World Peace Promotion Association, virtuous cultivators have dedicated themselves to completing the five grains frying to pray for a world of long-term stability, good harvests, and no war wholeheartedly. The treasurable ashes of the five grains will be scattered on the Wei Xin Sheng Jiao main altar as an offering to the spirits in the Dharma world. Let's learn more about the detail and listen to Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chan Shi's teachings.
The Guanzi Year Amitabha Buddha Birthday Celebration and Benediction Ritual for National Protection and Disaster Elimination, hosted by Tanjishan Wei Xin Sheng Jiao, is about to reach completion. During this 99-day period, all masters and lecturers of each branch temple led the volunteer fellows to support the ritual. Many fellow cultivators spontaneously came to help with the task of stir-frying the five grains as daily offerings for the altar. The chanting masters of Wei Xin Sheng Jiao Chanting College devoted for daily sutra chanting task continuously. In addition, the founder of Wei Xin Sheng Jiao, Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chan Shi, gave a brief instruction to fellow cultivators every morning during the ritual. Then, in the afternoon, he lectured Hun Yuan Chan Shi's elucidation of the majestic virtue of Wang Chan Lao Zhu for the heaven, human, and Dharma realms. Furthermore, Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chan Shi revealed his story of opening the Southern Heavenly Gate with the nine Bodhisattvas back to 38 years ago. The nine Bodhisattvas had a meeting in front of the golden dragon seat of the Great Jade Emperor in Southern Heaven, and they invited all the Bodhisattvas and deities who had descended to the mountain world from Southern Heaven to collectively turn the Dharma wheel of world peace. Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chan Shi elucidated the great vow of world peace to the mass as the offerings of the Dharma feast to myriads of pandemic in 196 nations around the world in order to resolve their grievances and hatred and to eliminate disasters. Thus, the Great Jade Emperor was piously invited to descend to the mountain world in order to sail his vessel to the five continents to secure the peace in the world. May all the grievances and hatred from all the spirits could be resolved and the pandemic of COVID-19 would end soon. Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chan Shi instructed to all the fellow cultivators as follows.
已经进入第八十八坛了，以易经卦象，天地正气的卦象来看，就是坤为地，大地春回。尤其这一次的疫情。 庚子年的疫情一直在环环的复，一直在循环，所以这个疫情对台湾人民也是一大威胁，世界各国受到的威胁非常严重。那么现在我们 生产法会，我们的重点还是先要把台湾顾好，把台湾大家能平安，世界就能和平，就能平安了。所以王禅老祖的大慈大悲啊，他的圣法就是开始要以广爱来照顾地球虚空大地的众生。由于众生的业障业力牵绊啊，到现在来一直在反复的在循环，这个也在提醒我们台湾的所有乡亲同胞们，我们要小心，尤其我们维新圣教所有维新弟子同学们，大家的呢啊努力修法修行，恭送诸经来护我息灾啊，这个是有非常肯定的真实意，所以我代表台湾人民向各位法师、各位讲师、各位维新贤士同修啊，向你们致感恩啊！唯愿呢啊，现在还在轰轰雨雨、轰声鹤唳的灾疫，反反复复还没有结束，很快的立春了，就会渐渐的好起来，大地春回，也是我们易经啊这个大道，物极都天都地，现在是都地，是完全阴面的大地，要让它升华至阳面的大地呢，啊，必须要到农历的十月份啊，才会有所看到绩效啊，这是业力啊，上天的惩罚众生啊，我们众生若是能及时悔改啊，过去的坏习惯啊，贪嗔痴杀抢业报等等的坏习惯的时候，能够修正了，那呢到农历十一月份啊，就可以见到绩效了。我们唯愿大家所求都能满愿啊，大家的护坛都这么辛苦啊，我也很感恩各位护坛的同修，大家放下手边的工作啊，来回来宣佛寺一起来祈祷，好，以大爱的方式，我们来自我修行，啊，这个是我们秉着王禅老祖给我们的为国修道、为人类祈福的最重要的事件呐。
维新 Report, The Headquarters, 显佛寺 Temple.
Take a break. We will come back soon.
维新电视台各时段。
For this week's Grand Master Hun Yuan Chan's footprint, we're heading to the Yellow Emperor Temple at the Sun Moon Lake to venerate the ancestor of humanity's Xuan Yuan Yellow Emperor. Let's take a look at the footage.
Only 5th, Chanqishan Wei Xin Sheng Zhao Grand Master Hun Yuan Chan visited the Yellow Emperor Temple at Sun Moon Lake to worship the ancestor of old Chinese descendants.He visited also to piously invite the Yellow Emperor to the 15th Chinese United Ancestor Worship Ceremony in 2021 at the Linkou Stadium. Grandmaster Wen Yuanchuan Shi burned the incense, piously praying for the Yellow Emperor to bestow safety and well-being to all Chinese students. Grandmaster Wen Yuanchuan Shi also chatted with the temple administration and the worshippers at the temple. He spoke of the status of the construction plan for a new Yellow Emperor temple. The new temple will sit behind the existing Yellow Emperor temple, which the Grand Master Wen Yuanchuan Shi has been the chairman of the board in preparation for the new construction. Grand Master Wen Yuanchuan Shi designated the location and took part in architectural planning. The groundbreaking ceremony took place in December 2017. Grand Master Wen Yuanchuan Shi has brought Weixin virtuous pharaohs to the Yellow Emperor Temple on field trips to explain the excellent feng shui of the location, as well as the Chinese cultural heritage dating back thousands of years to the Yellow Emperor, the ancestors of old Chinese descendants. It is hoped that obstacles could be overcome so that the construction of the new Yellow Emperor Temple can start smoothly, and that the new temple will continue to protect old Chinese descendants and pray for world peace. Weixin Report, Nantou.
Yijin University held the oath-taking ceremony for new students at Thousand Buddha Zen Ho of Changjishan Weixin Shenjiao Headquarters, Xianfo's Temple. Every cultivator of the fundamental classes has completed their oath under the solemn ceremony. Everyone is expected to utilize the wisdom embedded in Yijin Feng Shui wisely, self-protection, no harming others, lending a helping hand to others. Together, may everyone boast a safe and warm family. Let's take a look at the ceremony.
On December 6th, the oath-taking ceremony of Yijin University students took place at Thousand Buddha Zen Hall, where Master Yuan Long from Zhongli Branch Temple led 140 students from all over Taiwan to take an oath in the presence of Grand Master Wen Yuanchuan Shi. They took an oath of dedication to cultivating themselves, benefiting all sentient beings, and attaining world peace and enlightenment. After Master Yuan Jian, Director of the Office of Academic Affairs, introduced lectures of each class, Grandmaster Hui Yuanchuan Shi instructed the students.
你们很有福气啊。我今天开始讲寺庙风水漫谈。寺庙风水和住家风水、工厂风水完全相等。希望各位同学你们学好一本中文的妙法来学。其他外面武术界的朋友的书所写的你们可以看的和练习，但是要注意你们现在所学的法是我经过3600多年来证道了，3600多年来我在这一生把它传出来交还给各位，那相对的各位同修，你们跟老祖有约，才会在这一生大家再见面，一起来学道，一起来修行。所以我们易经大学是成人的教育，终身学习的课程各位同修，你们社会上的经验都很丰富了，也许你们比我有经验的也很多，但是我们在黄山老祖今年坐下，我们来学道就要重新开始打基础，不要急，你们进入中文来学到来学习易经风水，虽然时间很短，但是我们要耐心， 啊，我们大家已经仰仗王的老祖天威及列位祖师的天威，家属祝福大家会平安，在平安的状态之下，我们再来自我精进，这是很重要的啊关节点理念。希望各位同修呢，啊，你们要好好珍惜。
Grandmaster Huiyuan Chan Shi encouraged virtuous fellows to stick to self-cultivation. He added, Yi Jing Heart Dharma is a branch of learning without literally written books, and that it's time to develop its knowledge from the inner of our virtuous fellows and acquire the profound Dharma thanks to Wang Chan Lao Zhu's blazing.Also, Grandmaster Huiyuan Chan Shi reminded virtuous fellows they should be thankful to their lecturers who led them to the way of cultivation. Wei Xin Report, Changji Shanxian Fo Shi Temple.
Take a break. Let's move on to the latest activities of Wei Xin Sheng Jiao Branch Temples. The birthday of Mother Earth.Is on the 18th day of the 10th lunar month. Mother Earth is the governor of the lands and waters. With its great compassion, the earth nourishes and protects all living things. Adhering to Wang Chan Lao Zhu's holy revelation, in 2012, Wei Xin Sheng Jiao held the sinkholes and burrow disaster elimination ritual in which magnificent Dharma feasts were prepared as offerings.We are relying on the virtuous power of Mother Earth and the credits gained from reciting the scriptures to resolve the catastrophe of sinkholes. Mother Earth shares a deep bond with the religious culture of Wei Xin Sheng Jiao. Through today's report, we will be able to understand more about the Mother Earth birthday celebration ritual hosted by each branch temple.
18th of October of lunar calendar is the birthday of the Mother Earth. Each branch temple of Changjishan Wei Xin Sheng Jiao celebrated the birthday of the Mother Earth according to the ritual procedure and offered flowers, fruits, birthday peach buns, and noodles for longevity. Wei Xin Sheng Jiao, Grandmaster Huiyuan Chan Shi, showed the sympathy of the Mother Earth at Chongyang Ritual Altar.
金黄啊地母至尊的圣诞日，回顾2009年，啊，地球天坑地洞1150个天坑地洞，在地球各地造成地球的危机平衡，失去平衡。所以当时王禅老祖大慈大悲，啊，就要我们是速速生产，啊，恭送地母至尊真经来回向，来祈求地母至尊的慈悲，啊，来化解这个天坑地洞。的劫难，终于在11月17日佛诞日圆满的时候，啊，整个的地球又归于平衡平静了，就没有再有那么大的坑洞陷下去。尤其这个坑洞在中国大陆长江沿岸就有459个天坑地洞，我们很烦恼这个天坑地洞万一落在长江大坝，那就不堪设想。长江大坝下游将有3亿多 人民会受水患而 and more. 啊，这个是人类的浩劫。所以地由有地球以来无量劫来，在大地上啊，时时在发生战争，生生灭灭，时时生生。所以今天早上要加持地球的时候，大地臭尸满地，所以我们就请维新世界和平促进会理事长严毅法师啊，多洗净啊，我们同样都是来地球修行的。当然有一天人也会死，要回归大地，地母至尊毫无怨言的接受了我们人类的臭尸味污秽，尤其庚子年的武汉肺炎，地球死了几百万人，那么严重。所以今天地母祝尊的圣诞，我们祈祷地母祝尊大慈大悲啊，让众生能够远离瘟疫的劫难。
维新圣教 Virtuous Fellows express gratitude towards the sympathy from the Mother Earth. They celebrated the birthday of the Mother Earth according to the ritual procedure. They always bear in mind about the instruction from Grand Master Hun Yuan Chan Shi that there are traps everywhere. We have to learn to show generosity as the Mother Earth did. We should stay away from hatred and always forgive others.Once you open your heart and being generous, you are blessed. All of us are blessed. Wei Xin reports.
In the midst of COVID-19 outbreak, we would like to invite every global citizen to comply with the prevention measures by wearing face masks, washing our hands, no touching of our eyes, mouth, and nose, maintaining a safe social distance. Together, we should fight against the pandemic and protect the world's safety.Thank you for tuning in today. We will be back with more updates about Wei Xin Sheng Jiao. Please stay tuned at 11:30 p.m. on every Monday and 11:30 a.m. and 4 p.m. of the local time in Taiwan on every Tuesday on Wei Xin TV. May the pandemic end soon and people all over the world can enjoy a peaceful and harmonious life. See you next week.